गुड इवनिंग चिल्ड्रन, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर फोर्थ लेसन। टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग एक्सरसाइज 4A। इन एक्सरसाइज 4A द क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इज इवेलुएट 8 टू द पावर 3। दैट मीन्स वी हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई 8 3 टाइम्स। 8 मल्टीप्लाई 8 मल्टीप्लाई 8। व्हेन वी विल मल्टीप्लाई 8 3 टाइम्स, 8 इज 64 एंड 64 इज 512, that means 512 will be the answer. 15 to the power 3, that means we will multiply 15 3 times. 15 multiply 15 multiply 15, that will be 3375. Like this, in question number 2, we also have to multiply 1.2. We have to find out the cube of 1.2 and we have to find out cube of 0.8. so we will multiply these both number 3 times, then the answer we will get 1.728 of 1.2, and the cube of 0.8 is 0.512. next, we also have to evaluate the fractional number in the form of cube. Here first question is the cube of 4 upon 7. We have to find out the cube of 4 upon 7. That means we have to write down 4 3 times and 7 also 3 times, and we have to multiply. 4 to the power 3 means we have to write down 4 3 times. 4 multiply 4 multiply 4, and 7 also 3 times. 7 multiply 7 multiply 7. 4 4 is 16, 4 is 64, 7 7 is 49, 7 is 343 is the answer. Again, next question is 1 whole 3 upon 10 to the power 3. 10 1 is 10 plus 3. 13 upon 10 is a rational number. To the whole power 3, 13 we will write 3 times and we will multiply, then answer will be 2197. And again 10 will be multiplied by 3 times, then it will equal to 1000. Next question is, we have to find out whether the given number is a perfect cube or not. So if we will write, we will factorize 125, it can written as 5 multiply 5 multiply 5. That means it makes a proper triplet, therefore it is a perfect cube. Again, if we will take the factors of 243, then it will not make a proper triplet, so it is not a perfect cube. Again, if we are checking the 343, then 343 makes a proper triplet of 7, so it is a perfect cube. Now next question is, which of the following are cubes of even numbers? So 216, 512 and thousands, these all are even numbers. So above are cubes of even numbers, because cubes of even numbers is always even. Now in next, we have to check out whether the given number is perfect cube or not, or which number is required to make it a perfect cube. So 1323, we will take the HCF of this number. After taking the HCF, 3 4 is 12, 1 is left, 3 4 is 12, 3 1 is 3, 3 1 is 3, 1 is left, and 3 4 is 12, 2 is left, 3 7 is 21, 3 4 is 12, 2 left, this 27, 3 9 is 27, 7 7 is 49, and 7 1 is 7. So if we will write the factors of 1323, it will written as 3 multiply 3 multiply 3 multiply 7 multiply 7. So if we try to make a triplet, then only we are finding the triplet of 3. 3 multiply 3 multiply 3. If we are going through 7, then there is one 7 is short. We need one more 7 here. So to make it a perfect cube, we have to multiply it by 7. Our next question is, what is the smallest number by which 1600 must be divided so that the quotient is a perfect cube? The question is asking about that smallest number by which 1600 must be divided so that the quotient is a perfect cube. So now we will take the HCF of 1600. 2 8 is 16, it will be 800. 2 4 is 8, it is 400. 200 2s are 400, 100 2s are 200, and 50 2s are 100, and 25 2s are 50, and 5 5s are 25, and 1 5s are 5. Then we have all the factors of 1600. Now we will make the triplet of the given factors. Here we find triplet of 2. One triplet is here, second triplet is here, and now here is one short of 5. So therefore, to make the quotient a perfect cube, we have to divide 1600 by 5 multiplied by 5 is equal to 25. Thank you, class.